Hello everyone and welcome to another OpenIPC tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to install the new experimental, it's still under development, APFPV firmware. So basically stands for Access Point First Person View, APFPV. What that means? It means that the OpenIPC camera is creating an access point that is called OpenIPC with a password, of course, and then any ground station with any Wi-Fi adapter can connect just like a regular access point. That means it's completely simplified. It's widely available for many Wi-Fi adapters, not just two, three specific adapters, Wi-Fi adapters. And that's the one benefit of this firmware. The other very interesting benefit is that this stuttering that we experience in the OpenIPC regular FPV system is gone because it's not based on WFB anymore. It's just a regular Wi-Fi link and it does not have stuttering and it has less latency. So let's go ahead and see how to flash it. Of course, first thing we need to do is power on the camera and always use a fan while working on the bench. In this test, I'm using an Emax 100 milliwatt, but it will work this firmware on the RunCam WifiLink 2. Let's wait for the camera to power up. And then we open the OpenIPC configurator. Of course, we have already connected the camera directly to the laptop before we open the configurator. That's why we see the green light here. Then we go to the setup tab. And from this menu, we select one version of APFPV. I'm going to use the Greg07, but there is also the version from eGirl APFPV 1.1. And of course, there is the original version of the APFPV. And one more specifically for the eSheen camera with the one core, the single core, the 30KQ. But let's flash the Greg07. We click update. And then we click return. And then we do not touch anything until it finishes. Make sure to not interrupt the installation. Confirm the battery is enough for 1 to 2 minutes of installation. You do not want to interrupt this firmware update. And now that it shows this fatal error, we hit enter again, and we now have the new firmware from Greg, which is called APFPV Greg07. The next thing we need to do is set up our ground station. And in order to do that, I'm going to use the SBC 200 Beta 2 stock firmware, but we are going to flash the latest Pixel Pilot RK So let me power up my Emacs VRX. This will work best with the RunCam VRX that has the Realtek 8812 EU chip, but it will also work with other Wi-Fi chips. It is still unstable. It's unstable firmware, so it's still under development. Okay, let me enable. Now we need to enable the access point. And let me show you how to do that. You click one up or down button. You open the menu. Then you go to Wi-Fi and you enable the hotspot like so. Everything is happening with the buttons. This is the new menu of OpenIPC. And then you should see a new network here, the OpenIPC GS. You click connect, and then you select the RunCam Emacs VRX. Then you go to the VRX tab, and you click the install latest pixel pilot. You select yes. The system asks us to press return, and that's what we are doing. And then it will transfer the latest files on the VRX. And then we click return and return again to reboot the VRX. Now we enter in the menu again with this button. We enter in the system settings and we select from WFB to APFPV. We can switch between those two systems now from the menu directly. Now, if we power up the camera, that blinking pattern means it's searching for a ground station. And let's reboot the VRX. And now you can see that the pattern has changed. And we can have normal video. Oh my god, the latency is amazing. The bitrate is around 16 megabits per second. Yeah, all these settings can be changed, of course. 1080p 60 frames per second, but the latency, I think the latency is significantly lowered. I really need to test this on a drone and see the range. There are rumors that the range is not that great, but we have the WFB for long range and for short range with really low latency. Now we have the new system, the APFPV. So stay tuned for the maiden flight. Bye for now.